Welcome. My name is Erin. I'm so glad you're here with me this week. I'm so excited to open the Bible with you and talk about Jesus together. I want you to think about your favorite animal. What is it? I have a few examples of animals sitting up here. You have a giraffe, an elephant, a lion, and a zebra. Maybe your favorite kind of animal is a dog or a monkey. We all have different favorite animals. Why do you like the animal you chose? What makes it your favorite? We all have different favorite animals, and they're all good animals. All kinds of fascinating creatures live in our world. Some creatures swim, some creatures fly, and others crawl along the ground. Today, we'll learn that God made all the animals, as well as the different places where the animals live. The first thing we need to look at is our big picture question. That will help us know part of the big picture about what the Bible teaches us. I'll say it once, then I want you to repeat after me. Here we go. Who is God? Now, everyone, who is God? Great job. As you listen to the story today, we're going to find the answer to that question. We'll talk more about it soon. Just keep it in your brain. Who is God? Now that we know our big picture question, we're going to answer in our story, we need to check on where this story fits in the Bible. Did you know that the Bible is one book made up of a bunch of little stories? And all of those stories point to one bigger story about how God rescues us with his son, Jesus. Today's story is about the very first thing that happened in the whole universe. Before this story happened, there was no universe. There was nothing but God, who he had already existed. Our story is called God Created the World, and it is the beginning of the larger story of the Bible.
In the beginning, nothing existed except for God. God created the heavens and the earth. The earth had no shape, and darkness covered the earth. The Spirit of God was there, hovering over the waters. God spoke, "Let there be light." What God said happened. God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and he called the darkness night. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the first day. God spoke again. Let there be an expanse between the waters to separate them. What God said happened. He made a space between the water that was on the earth and the water above the earth. God called the expanse sky. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the second day. God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into one place, and let the dry land appear." What God said happened. God called the dry land earth, and he called the gathered water seas. God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth make plants and trees with fruits and seeds." What God said happened. Plants and trees grew, and God saw that it was good. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the third day. Next, God placed lights in the sky. God created the sun to shine during the day and the moon and stars to shine at night. God gave us lights to shine on the earth, to separate day from night, and to help us track time in days and years. God saw that it was good. Evening came, and then morning came. That was the fourth day. Next, God made creatures that move and swim in the water. He made birds to flap their wings and soar across the sky. God saw that it was good. God told the animals to multiply, and they filled the seas and the sky. evening came, and then morning came. That was the fifth day. Then God made more animals, livestock, creatures that crawl, and wildlife to live on the earth. When God said it, it happened, and God saw that all of it was good. Jesus is the Lord over all of creation. The Son has always existed. The Bible says everything was created by Him and for Him, and He holds everything together. All of creation exists to bring God glory.
That was a great Bible story. It comes from the book of Genesis, Genesis 1 in our Bibles. This story teaches us some important things about God. We know that He is powerful because he created the entire universe just by speaking. We know He is good because everything He made was beautiful and good. He said so. After He created everything, He said, "It is good." We also know that He's creative. Think about it. All of the interesting plants and animals in the world, God thought up each and every one from nothing. And because God made everything, that means He knows what is best, and He knows what is right, and He has the right to rule over everything. So now we can come up with an answer for our big picture question. Do you remember the question? Who is God? God is our creator and king. Why don't you say that with me? Who is God? God is our creator and king. God has authority. That means He has power. He gets to say what is right. He gets to make decisions over all of creation. He made the whole universe and everything in it, even things we cannot see. God created everything from absolutely nothing. No regular human can do anything like that. When we make or build things, we use parts that already exist, right? Think about the things that you build. You have to have tools or pieces to make something. When we need to make parts, we use metal, stone, wood, plastic. We can change things, but we can't create things from nothing. Only God can do that. I love learning what God thought about each new part of the world. Can anyone remember? God created many different things, but each time He made something, He saw that it was good. God did not create any bad things. God created everything, and everything He created was good. The Bible tells us that Jesus is the Son of God and the Word of God. In John 1 in the Bible, we learn that Jesus is God and that Jesus was with God in the beginning, during the creation of the world. Everything God created was created through Jesus. The Bible also tells us that all things are held together by Jesus. Jesus is Lord over all of creation. The Son has always existed. The Bible says everything was created by Him and for Him, and He holds everything together. All of creation exists because it is to bring God glory.
Hey friends, I'm Pastor Brian. It's time for questions from kids. Isaac from Rock Hill, South Carolina asks,
"Some of my friends believe different things about how everything got here. How do we know that God made everything?"
You know, that is a great question. The very first verse in the Bible tells us that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And then the whole first two chapters of Genesis tells us that God created the universe with order and purpose. Ultimately, we have faith that God is real, but we also have other reasons we can trust the Bible about God as creator. The Bible tells us that the heavens declare the glory of God, and the expanse proclaims the work of His hands. Whether colorful flowers or magnificent mountains, everything in creation points to God as creator. What are some ways that you've seen God's power and majesty in creation?
God's heart is for the world, the whole world. God loves every person in every city, town, and village, in every home, hut, and yurt. They speak different languages, they eat different foods, they believe in different things, and God loves them all. But they don't all know about God. Billions of people all over the world don't know about God's love. They've never heard of the gospel. They don't know that He sent His Son, Jesus, to rescue them, to give them hope. Not everyone knows, but they can, if someone goes to tell them. That's why God made me, to worship Him and to share His gospel. I'm still learning what it means to follow Jesus and what it means to be more like Him. But one thing I know for sure is that Jesus loves the world, the whole world. I want to love the world like Jesus. I want to be a kid on mission. I have a part in sharing the gospel with everyone, everywhere, right now.
God created everything, and everything He created was good. Billions of people on earth don't know that God loves them. God calls us to help others understand Him as Creator and King. That's a job we all have, and we all have people in our lives who we can share that good news with. Let's look at our key passage scripture. It's from Colossians 1:16b through 17. It says, "All things were created through Him and for Him, and He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together." Our key passage comes from the book of Colossians, which is in the New Testament of the Bible. Even though Colossians was written a long time after God created the world, it reminds us that Jesus has always existed, and that all of creation is under Jesus' authority.
This is my Father's word, and to my listening ears. All nature sings and around me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. Take comfort in the thought of rocks and trees, the skies and seas. His hand the wonders wrought.
Grab a Bible if you have one. We're going to look at Genesis 1. To find that, you can look at the very front of your Bible, and there's a table of contents. It shows you where each book is and gives you a page number. That way we can easily flip to each book of the Bible when we want to read there. There are big numbers that you'll see on the pages. Those big numbers tell us what chapter. So when I say, turn to Genesis 1, 5, the first number, that 1, is the chapter. So look for that big 1. And then you'll see little numbers. Those are the verses. So if I look for the 5, there's Genesis 1, 5. And then I can read that verse. If you need some more help learning how to look for certain parts in your Bible, you can talk to your parents, a brother, a sister, an aunt, an uncle, a grandparent. You can even find someone at church. You could talk to me, and we could talk about how to find different verses in your Bible. The Bible is separated into two main parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament tells us about the time before Jesus was on earth as a human, and the New Testament tells us about what happened while Jesus was on earth and after he was on earth. I want to talk about our Bible story from today, ask you a few questions about it. The first question, God said that everything he created was good. What does that tell us about God? Well, if everything he created was good, then that shows us that God himself is good. God is always good. How do we know when something is good? Sometimes it might be hard to decide between if something is a good thing or bad thing, but we can be sure that if God tells us something is good, that is good. God decides what is good. He defines good and bad. We can trust him. What is your favorite thing that God has created? God created lots of things, and you probably enjoy a lot of them. How do you feel when you think about the wonderful things that God has made? Think about flowers, trees, maybe your favorite animals. Think about the people in your life that you love. Those are all things that God created, and they make us really happy. It's important for us to remember that when something God created makes us happy, that we worship Him and we thank Him for that good creation. Our story about God's creating the world teaches us a lot about God. God is our Creator and King. It goes back to that big story question we asked. Who is God? God is our Creator and King. God deserves our worship because He created us, and He is perfectly good. At the end of our story today, the world was still perfect as God had created it to be. One day, Jesus will return and the world will be perfect again. Isn't that exciting to think about? There's a few questions I want to leave you with. These are great questions to think about when you read the Bible anytime. One, what does this story teach me about God and about the gospel? Think about our story today. What did you learn about God? It could be something you already know about Him, or it could be something that you didn't know before. But think about that. Maybe write it down or tell somebody else about what you learned about God. Another question is, what does this story teach me about myself? Maybe think about what things about you get to be like God. God made us to have characteristics like Himself, but there are also a lot of things that we are different than from God. Remember how we said that God created everything out of nothing? Well, we can't do that. We're not as powerful as God. But God did give us some really great characteristics that make us like Him and that we can become more like Him. And another question is, whom can I tell about this story? Think about the people in your life. Who needs to know that God loves them and that God is good? Who needs to know about Jesus and that God sent Jesus to rescue them? I'm so glad that we got to talk about the Bible today and got to spend some time together. I hope you go and tell somebody about the story we learned today, and I hope I get to see you next time.